So should the recommendations of the Prime Minister's panel be taken seriously? Autonomy has been proposed time and again in Kashmir, always hitting a dead end, this time with the added controversy that this has come from a group that hasn't met in 2 years. Let's get straight into our debate this evening. Saifuddin Soz joins us from Srinagar. Soz Saab, as the head of the Congress in the state, do you support the recommendations of this group? And how do you explain that it hasn't met for 2 years? You were also part of this group.
I have not yet seen the report, but since I was representing my party in the committee, I have a fair idea of what discussions had taken place. I think my impression is that discussions had been closed, but Justice Sagir took enough time to make out a report. But I want you to simplify the matter. You go step by step on the question of autonomy. It is a report now available with the Chief Minister. On the question of autonomy, on the discussion of autonomy, nobody should have difficulty. There are other proposals like self-rule. All documents can be discussed.
Okay.
My understanding is that whatever documents are there should come to the discussion table. And there has to be a dialogue to sort out all problems in Jammu and Kashmir.
All right.
I have no difficulty on discussing autonomy,
okay.
The quantum of autonomy.
Okay.
There are groups who would say there is already enough autonomy in the Constitution of India.
Yes.
There are others who will enlarge, who would want us to enlarge the autonomy. But no difficulty so far as discussion and dialogue is concerned.
The principle of autonomy.
Come to the discussion table.
Okay. Muzaffar Beg, why is that not a reasonable position? After all, your party has asked for self-rule. This group has recommended autonomy. Soz Saab is talking about this being the beginning for a discussion. Do you welcome this development?
Barka, let us first examine whether there is any definite recommendation made by Justice Sagir. He has said that the autonomy report of National Conference can be examined by the Prime Minister. Word is examined, not accepted. And with respect to PDP's self-rule, he has said that it was orally explained, but if the document is submitted to Prime Minister, he will consider it. So Prime Minister had not set up the working group for this divine revelation that he has the authority to consider the autonomy report or the self-rule report. It was set up with a view to see if the stakeholders and political parties in the state of Jammu and Kashmir can come to a consensus. What was expected that the working group would specifically point out with respect to autonomy, which provisions of the Constitution of India should be applied to the state of Jammu and Kashmir,
right,
and which provisions should be withdrawn. There is no such recommendation by the working group.
So you're saying
it was set up by the Prime Minister for getting a considered, consensual, consultative mechanism in place,
okay,
to narrow the differences between various political parties and stakeholders.
But then the question arises.
Then the question arises
that this is a group that hasn't met for 2 years. Chandan Mitra entered this. This is what the BJP has made its plank for opposition. But the fact is that even when the autonomy resolution was cleared by the Jammu and Kashmir Assembly, the then NDA government rejected it. Is your opposition to this report based on the fact that the group hasn't met for 2 years or to the very principle of autonomy?
No, of course there are issues. The question of autonomy should have been discussed threadbare in this working group. What was it set up for? If at the end of the day, it only says that the report should be examined, self-rule can be considered if the documents are provided. I agree with Beg Saab that, you know, what are the proposals? But the worst part, and that's what I want to underline. Number one, the group does not meet after 2nd, 3rd September 2007. So, and in writing it is stated, as Mr. Jaitley was saying, that it was promised that they would meet and before finalizing the report. It is not shown to any member of the group. Number two, why this timing? Do we have some reason to suspect that under American pressure, because this is the government of India's want these days, under American pressure, it buckles?
Isn't that too much of a conspiracy theory?
I don't believe so, because there was no reason why the group couldn't have met, why they couldn't have discussed the report.
Okay.
And obviously, because of the pressure that is coming from America to show some progress on this, I think the Prime Minister gave certain instructions. And the third point, that the report was submitted to the Chief Minister. It's the Prime Minister's working group, and why is the report gone to the Chief Minister?
Let me ask that question. Let me put that question to Mehboob Beg of the National Conference, joining us from Jammu tonight. Mehboob Beg, the Chief Minister has been handed over this report. Ironically, none of the people in the group have read this report. How do you respond to that allegation?
No, Barakat, the question is that recommendations from the working group have come, and recommendations very categorically endorse and support National Conference point of view so far as resolution of Kashmir issue is concerned. That's the question here. We are here debating on the recommendations made by the working group. It has vindicated and supported our stand so far as the resolution of Kashmir issue is concerned. That, and it has gone and it has said autonomy to a great extent.
But Mehboob Beg, why was this resolution not circulated among its members?
No, the question is not that. That you can ask them, not me. Question is, a resolution which was passed by the state, Jammu Kashmir State Assembly, cutting across the party barriers. You are insulting the state legislative assembly.
Yes,
which
you are right factually on that. In 2000,
from all the three regions of the state.
Yes, in the year 2000, that resolution was voted on by the Jammu and Kashmir Assembly. It's been gathering cobwebs since then. Sajjad Lone is somebody who's been both a separatist and tried to enter the mainstream electoral arena. Is there a lot of public misinformation about autonomy, about history, what history owed Kashmir?
Look, the problem is that when you talk of autonomy, autonomy is there in the academic literature of conflict resolution for the last 200 years. And now NCS monopolized this word. The truth is that it basically is a relationship or self-rule. They're almost same.
They're gradations of each other.
No, it's basically two names to the same concept, what powers you'll give to center and what powers you'll give to the provincial government. Now, I would say as an initiative it's good in the context of quiet diplomacy.
What about the questions that the BJP is raising about the group not having met for 2 years and so on?
To be very honest, I don't think it's a working group recommendation could have ever been taken seriously without the separatist participation. Mm. You see, they are a factor there. They have a hold on the sentiment and you can't just wish them away.
But the separatists would never take part in a working group set up by the Prime Minister.
There is a quiet diplomacy going on. In that context, if it is a means to an end, it's very good. It cannot be an end in itself. This working group recommendations means to an end, an initiative.
So it's a starting point for a dialogue.
A very good starting point if it is an expression of intent by the Indian government that they want to do business, they want to move forward, they want to break the status quo. It's very good.
All right, let me put that to Saifuddin Soz. Saifuddin Soz, since 2000, you've had an autonomy resolution that has been awaiting the center's action. Is the Congress government, is your government at the center going to take the proposals or the endorsement of the National Conference position on autonomy seriously?
Let me explain my understanding of the whole proposition. It was totally wrong on the part of NDA that time to have rejected, this document without even going into the report, and there was no discussion.
So, is your government going to do something different?
It was a great mistake. Today, before that, I will tell you one thing. I have no grounds that the committee did not meet, but the discussions had been closed. Now, Arun can say that. But you must know BJP has a basic difficulty. They have to play to the gallery. In the committee, I told Arun Jaitley that his case, BJP's case, that 370 should be abolished, abrogated, that is not possible. It cannot be abrogated. It cannot be changed.
Okay.
That is the constitutional position.
Okay.
So BJP has the basic...
Let me take that to Chandan Mitra.
So autonomy document... please listen to me.
Yes, sir.
The document on autonomy, the document the BJP has... Basic self-rule, and even Mr. Sajjad Lone's document, all these documents must come to the table. So I think you are correct in saying my impression is that is a starting point for discussion.
Okay,
I have no difficulty that you should be discussed.
Starting point for discussion.
And all shades,
All shades of opinion
fair enough.
Will be expressed.
Fair enough. I've got to take last comments now. Chandan Mitra, I remember it was Atal Bihari Vajpayee who said that insaniyat ke daire mein jo bhi mumkin hai, wo Kashmir mein ho sakta hai. Why isn't the BJP prepared to think imaginatively on Kashmir?
No, 1 minute. I want to ask Mr. Saifuddin Soz, who has been such a senior leader of Jammu and Kashmir, now he's in the Congress, that is the pre-53 status acceptable to the Congress party? Now, it was Jawaharlal Nehru who finished that. 1 minute, let me finish, Mr. Soz. Now, it is because it's the Congress which ended the pre-53 status, and in 75 there was a separate accord. The autonomy resolution talks about return to pre-53. If this is acceptable to Mr. Soz...
Okay, let Mr. Soz respond to that, and then I need to get Muzaffar Beg and Mehboob Beg. Mr. Soz, quick response, I need to take last comments.
I will say Chandan Mitra is essentially wrong. He has not seen the report.
No, are you prepared? The National Conference proposal is 353. The Sagir Ahmed proposal is 1975. His question is, are you prepared to accept pre-53?
There are various opinions. Some people will say autonomy already enshrined in the Constitution of India is enough. Others will say autonomy should be enlarged. Let all parties discuss.
We've been discussing for many years now.
When the parties come to the discussion table, they will come to the acceptable.
Muzaffar Beg, your last thoughts on this as we wrap up the show.
Barka, autonomy is a good idea. It's part of the formulation of self-rule. But we believe that no matter what kind of autonomy is granted to the state of Jammu and Kashmir, unless the matter is sorted out with Pakistan and the two parts of Kashmir, Kashmir problem will not be solved. It will be only a patchwork, and it will not resolve the issue of militancy or terrorism or bilateral tension between India and Pakistan.
All right, Mehboob Beg, your last word, very quickly.
Yes, please. It has made three very interesting observations about PDP. It says, in spite of the fact that PDP made a promise that they will come up with a self-rule document, they have not come. And it said that if at all they come up with some proposal, Government of India should listen to that proposal. So playing to the galleries, enough is enough. Now the only viable practical solution to Kashmir issue resolution, as it has said, is restoration of autonomy.
All right, basically both the PDP and the NC in a sense are competing to make greater devolution of powers, their own slogan. Very quickly, do you believe that the separatists, because there is quiet dialogue happening, are willing to look at autonomy, self-rule, whatever you want to call it?
Well, I couldn't speak for them, but I'll tell you one thing. Unless and until there aren't cross LOC majors, which is missing in the NC document, it won't move.
So you agree with Muzaffar Beg that you've got to involve Pakistan?
I think Muzaffar Beg agrees with me, because a lot of their document is inspired from other documents. So I think these separatists, they are the ones who have, at the end of the day, rendered sacrifices, gone to jails.
Well, that's a whole different debate, Sajjad. But Pakistan has to be involved in any...
I'm not talking of Pakistan.
But
I'm saying
the relationship between the two parts of Kashmir.
Cross LOC majors are very important.
All right, we'll have to leave it there. I think one thing for sure, it's a sensitive proposal, and it should have involved everybody, perhaps, in the group. Thank you, Saifuddin Soz, Muzaffar Beg, Mehboob Beg, Chandan Mitra, Sajjad Zone. Well, that's it on the Buck Stops here this evening. We'll be taking a Christmas and New Year's break. We hope you do the same. We'll see you again now in 2010. Good night. Thanks for watching.